one of me. I wish I knew.
What is up, Whitney?
It's Nevaeh.
And Jaylen.
Back to you with another Whitney High School Live.
Ooh, that was so in sync.
Yeah, it was not that special.
What do you know about special? Can you eat 4 hot dogs in one sitting?
Yeah, you can't.
Of course I can't. How do you even know you can do that?
I don't.
And I can't. I'm just messing with you. But it's gonna be so funny to see this hot dog eating contest. Let's watch.
Hey, Wildcats.
All right, so we're going to introduce each of our Glizzy Gobblers. All right, so for the seventh graders, who do we have here?
Kurt.
All right, what do you have to say?
I'm going to win.
All right, let's give a round of applause for Kurt. All right, for the eighth graders, who do we have?
Timothy.
Do you have anything to say?
I just don't want to get last.
Alright, he doesn't want to get last place. Ninth graders, who do we have?
My name is Chris.
Alright, Chris, do you have anything to say to the crowd?
I like to demolish Glizzy's day and night!
Alright, who do we have for the 10th graders? Joshua Wu. Joshua, what do you have to say to them?
I'm gonna eat all 24 Glizzy.
Joshua Wu's gonna eat all 24 Glizzy. Alright, we have my class, junior class right here, Edison Chan. What do you have to say to them?
I'm not gonna win, maybe, but I'm not gonna lose.
He's not gonna win, but he's not gonna lose. Alright, finally we have the senior Samar. What do you have to say to the crowd? Glizzy Overdrive! Oh! Alright, ready? Start Goblin in 3, 2, 1, go!
How about this? Okay, fine. You'll change your mind once you hear this satisfying ASMR segment.
Hi guys. So today we're gonna be doing an ASMR unboxing of this.
house. Don't even worry.
That was really satisfying.
Okay, guys, quick gossip time. You know the seventh graders run to the lunch line every single day? It's so cute.
You guys know that lunch isn't going anywhere, right?
They also think that Whitney's really hard, and I don't blame them. It does get pretty hard sometimes. We actually made a video about debunking myths and asked upperclassmen and faculty to answer for the little seventh graders.
Hosted by yours truly.
Yeah, whatever. Take it away.
Hey Wildcats, so today we're going to be debunking myths that 7th graders may have heard about Whitney High School. Okay, so who are we here with today?
I'm Arbiro.
Dean Andrew.
What's one thing you heard about Whitney before coming here?
That it has really smart people.
Do you think that Whitney High School is full of smart people?
Everyone's smart, from 7th to 12th to even SS teachers and administrators.
Okay, so who are we here with today?
Anishul Sishta.
Miss Alves.
Ava.
So what's one thing you heard about Whitney before you came here?
It's very small, and it's an amazing school. The teachers are super good.
Do you think that Whitney is a small and amazing school with good teachers?
100%.
100%?
Yes.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
The students, the environment is super good too.
Do you think that the students and environment at Whitney are really good?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
All right, so who are we here with today?
My name is Omkar.
Miss Improta.
Gregory DeVille.
What's one thing you heard about Whitney before coming here?
I heard that it's a lot of pressure.
Okay, all right, thank you. Do you think that Whitney High School is a lot of pressure?
Yes.
I don't have anything else to compare it to, but yes, but it's mainly like a parent kind of thing. Like me personally, I'm fine, but my parents like to put pressure on me.
All right, so who are we here with today?
Jaleen.
Ava.
I'm Mr. Perry.
Alyssa.
So what's one thing you guys heard about Whitney before you came here?
That it was a very smart school.
Do you think it's true that Whitney is full of smart people?
Yes, very much so.
All right, thank you.
That it was really hard to get into.
Do you think it's true that it's really hard to get into the school?
No. You just write an essay.
All right, so who are we here with today?
Rahi.
I am Dr. Keck Centeno.
What's one thing you heard about Whitney before coming here?
That it was like a really good school for like academics.
All right, so do you think that Whitney is a very good academic school?
Well, it is number one in the state.
Did you see that camera work? My camera work is flawless.
You know, isn't that special?
Oh, like the little fish.
What?
You know, that little unspecial fish.
Can you just speak normally for once?
Just watch.
Hey, I heard that you wrote a book. Is this true?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself and then maybe the book?
Yeah, so I'm Issa. I wrote the picture book, The Not-So-Special Fish, and it's a book about a fish who is kind of in a coral reef, and he's constantly, you know, comparing himself with other fish in the coral reef. And throughout the book, he kind of goes through a, you know, some exploration where, you know, he's able to discover how to better himself and, you know, stand out and be special. And yeah.
I think that's a sweet topic. What inspired you to write about it?
Yeah, so one of my big inspirations for writing the book was actually my grandmother. I used to volunteer at a community clinic in Southern California. And this clinic is in like an underserved community. And so when I was in that clinic, one of the things that I was able to observe a lot was, you know, the issue of access to healthy food and, you know, nutrition, especially in poor and, you know, families with less access to, you know, in underserved communities. And so I realized that, you know, that's something that I was passionate about and that I was interested in, you know, helping out and I guess kind of making an impact in a way that I thought would, you know, even if it was a small impact, something that could be somewhat helpful.
Yeah. What was the process like for you?
Yeah, so I started writing the book about, two summers ago, I would say. And that's when I just started, thinking of ideas and things that I wanted to do. One of the things that I for sure wanted to incorporate was actually a science or kind of educational aspect into the book, but I wanted to do it in a way where I didn't, compromise the integrity of the story, because I thought that, for kids to be interested in it, it had to be also, an interesting story. And so that's something that I did, and I published the book about a couple weeks ago now, and I'm really happy that, it became a bestseller, a number one new release on Amazon, something that I really didn't expect to happen.
Yeah, congratulations, wow. What are the main takeaways that you want people to grab from this book?
Yeah, so for readers, which are mainly, young kids, I would say one thing is, the ability to, be able to make change in your life. And obviously, it does deal with simple aspects of nutrition, but I think, broader terms, I think the ability to make changes and change your life for the better. And I also think, for people who are not exactly readers of the book, people who are older, I think, it's always a good thing to be able to make change. And so, yeah.
Yeah, is there anything else that you might want to share?
I just want to say, thank you to everyone who helped me, write the book, and anyone who, helped me in that way. And yeah, if you haven't already, buy your copy on Amazon.
All right, and then is that just how you get your hands on a book, just on Amazon?
Yeah, you can buy it as a paperback or ebook on Amazon, and look out for it on shelves on Barnes & Noble coming soon.
All right, thank you for telling us all about your writing and all that stuff.
Thank you.
I think that's a wrap.
I look so much better on camera than you do.
That's false. Anyways, we have some announcements. A Tufts University College rep will be here during lunch on Monday.
Also tomorrow night, there's a virtual college night for you seniors from 5:50 p.m. to 8 p.m. Make sure to come out for some good information.
Also, make sure to congratulate and wish Lauren Wang good luck. She's participating in the World Tap Dance Championship all the way in Germany.
Also, Shanti Club is having makeup auditions tomorrow during lunch behind the Mac.
And finally, did you guys know you guys can already pre-order the yearbook? Early bird pre-sale is $85, which sounds like a lot compared to the original price of the year. But compared to the original price of over $90, I think it'd be best to just get it now.
Yeah, and the sale ends on September 30th. Make sure to hurry.
All right then, we're wrapping it up here. Thanks for tuning in, Wildcats.
Also, if you have any announcements, please make sure to call us on whitneyhs.live at abcusd.us. Thanks.
See you guys.